Standing here in a rest area about 87 miles east of Amarillo and 15 miles west of Memphis. Twitty's fixing to drop an Obama. Folks, this is Encyclopedia Duke Brando coming to you from a rest area 70 miles east of Amarillo. Look at this view behind me. Not a goddamn thing out here. Nowhere. Miles. It's pretty. No Obama lovers. Hey folks, this is Encyclopedia Duke Brando again, and this is the third video for June 20th. Tomorrow is the first day of summer, and Monday is my 38th birthday. I am celebrating with a week-long vacation. Some would call it torture driving through the state of Texas. Being as I've driven almost 600 miles and I'm still in the son of a bitch, and I'm gonna drive another 600 back to get to Tyler, and I'm never leaving the son of a bitch. But it's okay though, it's a beautiful state. It is like a whole other country. There's my Twitty bird. Twitty bird. Say hi, baby. Say hi to the Hollywood camera. Say hi. Say hi, baby. She says hello. This is our route. This is Interstate 40 going through Amarillo. And we're coming up on our exit right now, exit number 65. And it's Coulter Street. We're staying at the La Quinta. Yeah, baby. Mama's back at the hotel room with my Twitty bird. My Twitty bird took the trip with us and she made it just fine. She had a blast. She dropped an Obama at almost every rest stop that we went to. Hey folks, this is Encyclopedia Duke Brando coming to you live and on Memorex from Amarillo, Texas. This is the third day of my week-long vacation, and I've just hit the mother load. I went to the second Hastings in Amarillo, and I will do a second video when I get back to the hotel, which is very shortly, and we will be telling you what records I got. I got some good ones. They were on sale too, 25% off of everything used, and all that jazz. So just bear with us, and I'll have a video for you very shortly. Hasta luego. Good morning, folks. This is Encyclopedia Duke Brando coming to you live and on Memorex from Amarillo, Texas. This is day 4 of the vacation, and we are heading to Littlefield and then on to Lubbock today. So, Littlefield is the hometown of Waylon Jennings, and I will be stopping there, and I'll take some pictures and do a little video from there and post it to YouTube, so stay tuned.
I was just 15 and out of control. Lost to James Dean in rock and roll. I knew down deep in my country soul that I had to get away. Hollywood was a lady in red who danced in my dreams as I tossed in bed. I knew I'd wind up in jail or dead if I had to stay. I thought happiness was love of Texas in my rearview mirror. My mama kept calling me home, but I just did not want to hear. And the vision was getting clearer in my dreams. So I lit out one night in June, stoned on the glow of the Texas moon, humming a nobody holler tune called Peggy Sue. Peggy Sue. With my favorite jeans and a cheap guitar, I ran off chasing a distant star. Buddy Holly could make it that far. I figured I
could too.
And I thought happiness was love of Texas in the rearview mirror. My mama kept calling me home, but I just did not want to hear her. And the vision was getting clearer in my dreams. But the Hollywood moon didn't smile, same old smile that I've grown up with. The lady in red just wanted my last dime. And I cried myself to sleep at night, too down to run, too scared to fight, and too proud to admit at the time. So I got me some gigs on Saturday nights, not much more than orchestrated fights. I come home drunk and I try to write, but the words came out wrong. Hell-bent and bound for a wasted view, too much gin and not enough vermouth. No one to teach me how to seek the truth before I put it in a song. I still thought happiness was love of Texas in the rearview mirror. My mama kept calling me home, but I just could not hear her. And the vision was getting clearer in my dreams. Well, I thank God each and every day for giving me the music and the words to say. I'd have never made it any other way. He was my only friend. Now I sleep a little better at night, and when I look in the mirror, morning light. The man I see was both wrong and right. He's going home again. I guess happiness was love of Texas in my rearview mirror. But now happiness is love of Texas growing nearer and dearer. And the vision is getting clearer in my dreams. I think I finally know just what it means. And when I die, you can bury me in Lubbock, Texas, in my dreams.
Hey folks, this is Encyclopedia Duke Brando coming to you live and in Memorex from La Quinta on Avenue Q in Lubbock, Texas, hometown of Buddy Holly, Mac Davis, and many others, and also the hometown of Texas Tech Red Raiders, my school. Yeah, baby. And yes, the hair is completely gone. This is day four of vacation, and I've got 4 days in Lubbock, so I'm going to see some family later today. I just wanted to give you all a heads up. Everything is rocking and rolling up here. It's nice, and we'll holler at you later. Hey, folks, this is Encyclopedia Duke Brando and my lovely little traveling companion, the Twitty Bird. We're coming to you live from Lubbock, Texas, about 6:20 in the evening on June 21st, 2014. You look out that way, you see the skyline of Lubbock, Texas. You can't really see it all that good, but that building, it's the tallest building there, is the NTS Great Plains Life Building. Mama worked in that building in the late 60s and early 70s. And that building was actually shaken and twisted by an F5 tornado at 9:35 in the evening of May 11th, 1970. The building was twisted and thought to be in beyond repair damage, but they fixed it, and you walk up to it, you can still see the damage to it. And we're talking 44 years later. Anyway, this is my favorite city. This is my hometown, and I'm glad to be back. Happiness is Lubbock, Texas, growing nearer and dearer. Twitty bird. There you go. She don't want to look at the camera. She looked at too many cameras in jail. Good morning, everybody. This Encyclopedia Duke Brando coming to you live and on Memorex from Lubbock, Texas. I just had a wonderful breakfast at a Lubbock institution that's been around since 1961. It's a place called the Pancake House. And if you're ever in Lubbock, Texas, and you want a damn good breakfast, go to the Pancake House. This place has literally been around since 1961, and when you walk inside, it has a nice old feel to it. Great mom and pop place in Lubbock, I tell you that much. I have a keen sense on these mom and pop places, and Pancake House certainly foots the bill. Anyway, we're going to be visiting with some family today, and Twitty Bird and me will be taking us a little walk, and tune in later today, and we will be live and on Memorex from Idaloo, Texas, and look forward to it because it's family. My favorite aunt and one of my cousins and mother and myself and Twitty Bird, we're all going to get together and split a herring and have some fun and have some good old times and talk. So with that, I bid you all a good day. And oh, by the way, the street that we're on right here in Lubbock, Avenue Q and Mac Davis Lane. Mac Davis is a songwriter, wrote many big hits for artists. Most notably, he wrote In the Ghetto, Don't Cry Daddy, A Little Less Conversation, Memories, Charo, for a guy named Elvis Presley. Now, a little piece of history about Elvis and Mac Davis. Elvis played here in Lubbock. Played a Cadillac dealership one afternoon on the back of a flatbed pickup truck. Mac Davis was a little 13-year-old kid who saw this show, and he wrote a song about it called Hooked on Music, which went on his Texas in My Rearview Mirror album. That evening, Elvis played Coronado High School here in Lubbock. Played in the auditorium, that is. There was a bluegrass troupe that opened up for him named Buddy and Bob. Bob Montgomery and Charles Hardin Holly, otherwise known as Buddy. Waylon Jennings was also in that audience that night, and he worked as a disc jockey at KLLL. Later that weekend, Elvis played Odessa, and he played the Roy Orbison television show in Midland and Odessa area. So in the course of one weekend here in the South Plains, you have about six people that would later go into music. Buddy wasn't really far behind Elvis. Anyway, that's a little history about this place. There's something in this water here in Lubbock. I don't know what it is, but you look down through the years and you see how many people come out of this town that were famous, and you'll start to understand there's something in this fucking water. And trust me, I'm drinking the shit out of it while I'm here. Have a good day. Hey, folks. We are in just north of Idaloo, about 8 miles. If you see completely around me, there is nothing. It's beautiful. No sirens, no gunshots, nothing. Just country land, farmland, cotton fields. That right there is a piece of the Cap Rock coming down from West Texas outside of Justiceburg and on the way to Snyder on Highway 84. That is a damn beautiful mountain.